Why did Baldur say we cost?
Odin must have convinced him that following you to Jotunheim would bring his cure. Lies, I'm sure.
Why did Mistletoe break the spell?
Vanir magic is powerful, but its rules are slippery and elusive. I'm sure it makes sense if you're a witch. Oh, but it's also bloody tragic. Baldur was the greatest gift Odin granted Freya. The one thing she treasured from their marriage. She only hoped to spare him pain and spare herself loss. But such impulses can lead good parents to make terribly stupid decisions.
Ymir, you never told me what happened with the stonemason's son.
Hrimthor, son of Thamur. After completing his father's masterwork at the Great Wall of Jotunheim, he thought of nothing but making the Aesir pay for their crimes against the giants. Once, he longed to fight Thor, but tragedy had brought wisdom to Hrimthor and cunning. He observed that Asgard's walls were half-built and shoddy, for no Aesir god could be bothered with such tiresome labor. So Hrimthor adopted the guise of an ordinary man and made the Aesir an offer. He would build them majestic new walls, and if he couldn't build them within 2 turns of the season, they would owe him nothing for his labours. And if he succeeded, he asked only for an audience with the goddess Freya. Odin agreed, knowing the task was impossible, but intrigued by the stranger. Hrimthor made short work of it, of course. He had the benefit of his father's training and the aid of a magical stallion for fetching stones. Odin was not happy to find himself on the losing end of the wager, but he seemed to uphold his end of the bargain. Freya was sent to meet the mason, and to her surprise, he wanted only to whisper something in her ear. That being done, he made his way out of Asgard. And when he found Thor awaiting him at the gates of Midgard, he knew he had been double-crossed. But he didn't care, because his plan was complete.
It was? What did he say to Freya?
Only she could say for certain, but I've had many moons to work it out. Hrimthor knew that Freya loathed the Aesir, despite her marriage to Odin, and I believe he gave her the secret to Asgard's defences. Some weakness he may have built in, structural or magical, which I expect will be exploited come Ragnarok when Surtur arrives to burn Asgard to ash, if not sooner.
This will be our best work yet. Just need a little help from you lot.
Here we go! I can't believe we're gonna see the giants!
Well, if things work according to plan... Go ahead and lock in Jotunheim and we'll be on our way.
Hope this doesn't cause you to explode or anything.
Oh, hadn't considered that. Maybe we should talk about this a bit more.
Nah, I'm sure it'll be fine. Ready?
Oh, that's unpleasant!
Now, boy!
See.
A word, please, before we continue. Listen, the last thing you two need up there is a decomposing heat ruin in the moment. Why don't I wait for you here? This is between you and the boy.
True. But if someone were to fight...
My Lady Sif's soft, perfect sloshers. You done did it.
Sorry. We had to see this.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. Fine, damn it. Fine.
Watch the head till we return.
I can do this. No, no, I can't. Oh.
Okay.
Ready. Come.
Look! We're on the giant's fingers. I can see the highest peak ahead. Right over there. We did it.
We did.
What are you doing?
I have nothing more to hide.
Can we go now? We're so close.
Boy. Boy.
It's nothing. I just thought I'd hear voices by now. Hello? Anybody here?
What is this place?
They must have all come through here when they left Midgard. What was left of them.
Why carve all these faces?
What if this is all the giants that got out of Midgard alive? Not really many at all. Odin and Thor, ruining everything for everybody.
Where are they now?
The giants came back home so they could survive. But I'm not sure they did. Huh. Who's the guardian? I should feel them, but I don't. This place is dead. What happened to them? Why did Mom send us here?
One question is answered, and two more take its place.
Something's happening. It's your axe. It's Muller. Look. She's arguing with a bunch of giants. She... new giants? That's us. The first time we met the world serpent. But how? And our fight with Baldur. But that just happened. Wait. They knew everything that was going to happen. The dragon in the mountain, the stone mason, all these drawings. This is our story.
No. This is your story.
But what does it all mean?
That I was not the only parent with secrets.
You didn't know. She was a giant. I'm a giant. Why didn't she tell us?
She sent us here knowing we would find this.
Why not just tell us the truth?
Your mother would have had good reasons. Baldur was never sent to find me. He was tracking her all along, not knowing she was only ashes.
If she had a plan for us, I trust it. Whatever it is. Besides, she hasn't been wrong yet. Come on. We're so close to the end now.
Yes. Yes, we are.
Look, it's Mother's. She was here. She saw every step we took before we took it. Like she was always with us. Watching over us. Leading us home. Let's finish it.
No. We do it together. Son. Goodbye, Faye.
I love you, Mom. The Giants. They really are all gone. There's nothing for us here.
Come.
So, I get that Mother was a giant. Which makes me part giant and part god.
And part mortal.
Right. I guess there's just one thing I don't understand. My name on the wall. The Giants called me Loki?
Loki? That's the name your mother wanted for you when you were born. She must have called you that to her people.
But why?
A question for another day. Let us go home.
This here? Is this what she wanted us to see? Did she want us to tell the people or keep it a secret?
I do not know.
So what should we do?
I trust you to decide that.
Oh. So why'd you want to name me Atreus? I know it can't be for a god.
No. He was a soldier. A Spartan.
A great warrior?
All Spartans are great warriors. We trained from birth. Our lives were discipline, duty, battle, and death. Life was grim, and we greeted it grimly. But Atreus of Sparta was unlike the rest of us. He wore a smile even in the worst of times. He was happy. He inspired us to hope that though we were machines of war, yet there was humanity in us. Goodness. When the day came for him to lay down his life in battle, his sacrifice saved countless others and turned the tide in our favor. I carried him home on his shield and buried him with all the honors of Spartan custom. His memory was a comfort in dark times.
Wow, you actually told a good story. And we missed it. My mom sent us out here, too. I mean, what would Atreus of Sparta do?
And what would Loki do?
Huh. That's a weird name. I'm glad we went with yours.
Lads, am I glad to see you. I've reached my limit for dwarven charm.
What happened, Mimir?
They took an uncomfortable number of measurements and then proceeded to bicker about the weather.
Where do you want us to take you?
How about the warm confines of anywhere bloody else? Before we return to Midgard, I should warn you. More time has passed than you likely realize. The snowfall that began when you slew Baldur has become something else. The stuff of omens.
Omens for the coming of winter.
Not just any winter, but a great winter to span three summers. And when it's done, Ragnarok begins.
Ragnarok from snow.
Aye, snow. Lots more snow. And then the end of the bloody world, in that approximate order.
Another prophecy.
No, brother. Prophecy doesn't expect this for 100 more winters at least. You've changed something. Prophecy didn't count on you.
I'm telling you, it's Fimbulwinter. I can feel it in my scroat. This is the big one.
Stop saying that. Oh, you're making me very nervous. It was bound to snow sooner or later.
That ain't just snow, and you know it. It's the end times.
How dare you make me the voice of reason?
Guys?
Just discussing the weather. Bit of a cold snap lately.
What he means is, Fimbulwinter's upon us, boys. The winner to end all winters. I can feel it in my scroat.
Yeah. We heard.
So, if you're heading home, try to keep moving. And also, to not die.
Or if you're not heading home, same advice.
What's it gonna be this time? We got that taken care of. Hey, nobody's twisting your arm.
Atreus, follow me.
If I'm not mistaken, we've yet to discuss the tale of the giant Bergelmir.
Oh yeah, I remember his shrine. It looked happier than the other ones, mostly.
It begins in an ocean of blood.
Finally, a story worth hearing.
If you remember, Ymir, the first giant, was fatally stabbed by Odin. It's in his blood our story starts. Ymir's magical guts poured out in a torrent so violent it threatened to flood all of creation. The Jotnar were unprepared, as the very last of them were washed away in the endless tide. Not just Ymir, but all of giant kind faced extinction. And so would Odin's victory have been complete. But Ymir's kind did not all perish that day. Staying afloat in the hollowed husk of a tree, the frost giant Bergelmir endured, as did his lady wife. For weeks they sailed, until finally they came upon a new land. They called it Jotunheim. And there they would start anew. As father and mother, they would multiply exceedingly, and as king and queen, they worked to make Jotunheim a land where giants would know no master but themselves. Bergelmir never sought revenge for Odin's slaughter. His vengeance was to live and prosper. He died at peace, a legion of his kin to mourn him. He would ever be known as Bergelmir the Beloved.
Bergelmir the Beloved. Huh. I've never heard a story end that way. Not a true one, anyway.
If you do, laddie.
There. Another name.
Here.
Focus up.
Something down there. That dragon, it's Baldur's, isn't it?
Yes.
And you brought it down to save me?
It was very heroic.
I wish Mom were here. Huh.
Atreus, to me.
Okay, coming. What happened to the city?
I'm not entirely sure, lad. It was abandoned long before Jormungandr came to town and flooded the place.
I wonder what it was like to live here.
Enemies ahead!
Nicely done!
Another name. Ulrich.
by yourself!
Got any more giant stories, Mimir?
Well, if you see any more shrines about, you can always ask.
I see something down there. I wonder what happened to this ship's crew. Thank you. think we have a complete set of those now.
Atreus, follow me.
Be right there.
Thank you. Done here.
All right, last one. Gunnar, look! That should really help us fight the rest of the corrupted Valkyries.
Boy.
It says, "Glory to Motsignir, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace."
Greetings!
And welcome to Konungsgard. I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break.
Whoa. Look! It's another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Chain. I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
One vicious son of a bitch.
Captured more than one dragon. He must have needed them to create this legendary armor.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Scales, even excrement.
Excrement?
Shit.
Dragon shit is powerful?
Aye, lad. Potently powerful.
The head is having fun with you.
Oh, I need...
One, brother.
Ugh! That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them, at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
To find out, but they're rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
I think this dragon would be a bit more supportive, seeing how we're trying to free it.
Not yet.
don't look too good. Have you considered a tactical retreat?
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir.
Huh. Neat.
Thank you. tough fight.
Stone number two. This place is even bigger than Vadergar.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
I wonder what happened to him.
It is a great mystery, even amongst the sons of Ivaldi. Mortsognir's behavior before his disappearance grew increasingly erratic.
Why?
The Dvegrath Eaker, the very armor you find yourself searching for. Though he found two, I'd wager his failure to find the third ingredient drove him to madness.
Looks like it needs three entry stones.
There's no key back there.
Get it!
Impressive!
Yeah.
Atreus, follow me.
Sorry, I got distracted.
Mimir, why did the Dwarf King want this armor so badly? What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dvegrath Ikar. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
Well, what can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble, and rarely does it pay off.
If you say so.
Greetings, and welcome to Konungsgard.
Expect.
I don't know. Same, I guess. Maybe the throne room's a better shape.
Another one here.
Starcutter. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
6, 7, 8? Could he shoot 4 bows at once?
More of a swordsman. He did only have the 2 eyes.
It looks like Thor cut him down to size.
It's what he does.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. and screams. Large crowd of people.
Just...
They're getting louder. They sound almost like...
There's a passage behind this throne.
A secret passage?
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
I may want to write that down.
The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with... whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
That's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
Thank you. This place looked like in better times.
Conan's Gard was a beautiful land in its heyday, before the Dwarf King's obsession poisoned his mind.
How could he let that happen?
The Dwarf blindly trusted in the legend and pursued it without thought to the consequences. This is the result.
Trust is a gamble, like you said. And the Dwarf King lost.
You found the legendary materials? Incredible. Oh, this is so exciting. Meet me back at the temple and we'll get started right away.
go free.
Atreus, to me!
The tower ate the Unity Stone, didn't it? I wanted to fly again.
Yes, that's a terrible pity.
Why is Odin so desperate to find a way into Jotunheim anyway?
He's convinced the giants hold the key to changing his fate when Ragnarok comes. They are the Aesir's oldest enemies, after all. And it's their army that's supposed to do him in the end. But more than that, he covets their gifts of prophecy. He wants to know what they know and see what they see. So much suffering could have been avoided if his insatiable curiosity was not so much stronger than his wisdom.
What do you mean?
Ah, remind me to tell you why they call him the Lord of the Hanged.
You boys look right beaming. Well, the squirt does.
They found the materials. But they're so weird. How do you build a piece of armor out of something so... so...
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya fucking business. Trade secret. We got our ways.
Oh.
Now you're talking. Don't scuff that up.
What else do I want to tell you?